If you've been diagnosed with a pituitary adenoma or related tumor that may require surgery, this brief video describes the latest minimally invasive techniques our surgical team uses to achieve safe and effective tumor removal while promoting a rapid and more complete recovery. Endonasal endoscopic surgery uses the nostrils as natural corridors to remove pituitary adenomas and other midline skull base and brain tumors. This minimally invasive approach involves two surgeons working together using a high-definition endoscope and refined low-profile instrumentation. To reach the skull base and pituitary, mucosal incisions are made in the back of the nasal cavity that aim to preserve the blood supply to the mucosa and the sense of smell. The mucosa is elevated from the back of the nasal septum and sphenoid bone. The natural openings of the sphenoid are then widened and connected, creating a corridor to the skull base and pituitary. This allows the surgeon to maneuver two instruments within the sphenoid sinus while being illuminated and visualized by the endoscope. Next, the bone of the skull base over the tumor and pituitary gland is removed. Prior to opening the dura, which covers the pituitary gland and tumor, the Doppler probe is used to precisely localize the carotid arteries. The dura is then opened and lifted upward, revealing the pituitary tumor and compressed gland. For large tumors, such as the one shown here, the lower portion is removed first using microinstruments and suction. The remaining tumor is separated from the surrounding normal structures, most importantly, the compressed pituitary gland, to help preserve or restore its function. The entire cavity, including the walls of the cavernous sinus, is then carefully explored with angled endoscopes to make certain that all safely accessible tumor has been removed. Following removal, the tumor cavity and bony opening are typically covered with a small piece of harvested fat and bone, which are held in position with collagen matrix and tissue glue. The endonasal approach is also used for many midline skull base and brain tumors, such as meningiomas. Craniopharyngiomas. And clival chordomas. In such cases, more extensive skull base exposure and closure is usually required, including use of specialized vascular flaps to help prevent postoperative spinal fluid leaks. After endonasal endoscopic pituitary surgery, on average, most patients are out of the hospital within 48 hours and back to full activity within 2 to 3 weeks. For more information, visit us at www.brain-tumor.org or call 310-582-7450.